and welcome to Technique in Practice with Inspiro Coral. My name is Anna Marie Ryan, and today we're going to talk about posture. Specifically, this video addresses the question, what are we trying to achieve with proper singing posture? In my mind, I like to think of two specific goals when I'm focusing on improving my posture as a singer. The first goal is to eliminate tension. Anytime we carry physical tension in our bodies, that's going to affect the sound that we're able to produce. So a good rule of thumb to remember is that tension inhibits a relaxed vocal sound. Some of the ways that tension might manifest in our everyday posture, particularly when we're singing, could be in raising of the shoulders, for example. This is a very common one. If our shoulders are not back and down and relaxed, they might start to creep up, which creates tension in our neck and affects our vocal mechanism. The other ways that we might have tension that we're not aware of could be maybe clenching our fists or tightening our arms, or also curling our toes underneath us instead of having a nice flat foot on the floor. Other options could be having our knees locked or just having a little bit of a stiff posture in the body in general. So we want to work to be aware of these habits of tension and eliminate them over time so that our singing production can be more relaxed. The second goal that I like to keep in mind with singing posture is that we want to allow for the most efficient use of our breathing mechanism as possible. So what do I mean by that specifically? Well, for example, our breathing mechanism, as we know, is centered in our core. It includes our lungs, our ribs and rib muscles, the intercostals, as well as the abdominal muscles and the diaphragm. So anytime we make changes to our posture that does not allow for all of this to be open and relaxed, we're going to basically get in our own way as singers by preventing that open, relaxed, full breath that we want to achieve to carry our phrases. For example, one poor posture habit that might affect your breathing is to collapse the chest a little bit. So anytime we have the shoulders rounding in just slightly even, we are preventing the ribs and the lungs from fully expanding when we take our breath. Another example of poor posture is actually something that we might consider to be proper posture, which is when we stand up straight, we think, oh, the straighter you stand, the taller you stand, the better for singing. This is not always the case because you can always take things too far. So for example, if I'm overextending my chest and standing really tall, which usually involves tilting my chin up at the same time, I'm actually disconnecting from my ability to use my abdominal muscles to control my breath, because I'm so overextended and I'm creating, as you can see, tension in my shoulder area and in all of this core that I require for my breathing to be relaxed. So those are the two goals to keep in mind. We want to work towards eliminating tension so that we can have a more relaxed vocal sound production. And we want to focus on ways that allow our breathing to be nice and open, relaxed, and the most efficient as possible. More information on breathing will be available in upcoming videos. The last thing to keep in mind is just that awareness is key. As a singer, especially if you're just beginning to explore some of these concepts, you have to keep in mind that the first goal is just to notice what you're doing, where you're carrying tension, maybe how your breathing is being affected by your posture, and then you can start to address and correct those poor habits. Thank you so much for watching, and we look forward to having you join us with future videos on Inspiro Coral.